Assalamu alaikum. My name is Aishath Looba and I am currently working at Islanders Education as a senior manager for inclusivity. My work includes working with all the schools run under Islanders Education to ensure that our schools establish inclusivity to enable all children, regardless of their differences, get the opportunity to learn within the school community. And I am also a resource person for Care Society, which is actually where my work began in 2001. Care Society is an NGO working in the disability sector in the Maldives. And today I'm going to highlight a little bit about what are the issues faced by Maldivian women when especially working in different sectors and how we contribute to the community in general. And I would like to begin with highlighting that the issues that we face often in the communities is not only coming from community itself, it's coming from the household, it's coming from the workplace, and sometimes these are linked as well. And most of these are coming from different mindset or from the way that we have been thinking for a long time. And these perceptions and attitude towards what women should be doing, what women shouldn't be doing, is actually contributing to the real life of women ourselves. And I think it is something that we need to understand, that these perceptions and attitudes actually play a huge role in making the community more accessible or right-based oriented for women to be equal partners, or decreasing these differences between men and women in order to contribute to the society. And the first thing I would like to talk about is the type of jobs that we expected to do. And in many cases, that even in the Maldivian community, we expect that women to do more caring jobs, like for example, teachers, nurses, or caring for elderly or children. These are more perceived to be jobs that women should be doing. And it is often carried out by a lot of women. Like in many places that you would observe that there are more women than men in this sector, like for example, nursing or teaching. And it is also areas that we really need men to be part of. But that perception or stigma that men shouldn't be doing these things actually makes it difficult for men to be a part of it, as well as women to be more engaged in these things. So this is something that we really need to think about, and something that really impacts our work environment as well. And then comes the issue of working. Like a lot of women are now working, and you will observe that Maldives to be a very liberal community where you will see women everywhere and they are going to work and they are engaging in different activities, which is very good. But at the same time, how are we really engaging in these activities is something that we really need to think about. For example, you are expected to go, if you're working, you're expected to work for, let's say, 8 hours a day. And when you come back from work, you are again expected to do everything that you are supposed to do at home as well. In many cases, men are not very much perceived to be someone who should be contributing to the household chores. But women, on the other hand, are expected to do these roles, are expected to contribute to household chores, and also take the responsibility in taking care of the children. And I'm sure that there would be a lot of males you will find in Maldives who are very much part of these household chores. But I'm talking in general, across country, that these mindsets are still very, very vivid, and it exists even the mindset of women themselves who believes that they are supposed to be taking care of their family and all the household chores falls under them rather than sharing it or working it with a partner. And you will also observe that across the island communities in the Maldives, there are a lot of men who are working away from home, which again puts a lot of burden on the women. So women are going to work, women are contributing to the societal development. Also, women is responsible to take care of the elderly as well as the children in the home. So when you think about all these roles that women are expected to play in the community, it's actually a very huge burden on them. And often not all women want to talk about it, because that opportunity that they get to work is actually a very, very important part of their well-being. A lot of women want to have that, regardless of how busy or how hectic their life can be. When they get that opportunity to work and contribute to the society, they believe that is something that is liberating them. So not many people would talk about it, and a lot of people will believe, okay, this is my responsibility, this is something I can do. And sometimes we, among women, we believe that, okay, being a superwoman or super mom or a super worker is to be able to juggle all these roles at the same time. But in reality, that is something that we really need to think about. Why do we put all this burden on ourselves? Why do we let the society put all this burden on ourselves? So we believe that all these things has come with a lot of years of perceiving that women has to do a certain role in the community. While men themselves are not expected to learn to become more accepting of this ideology. They're happy, for example, they may be happy that women are working. They are contributing to the economy of the household as well. But at the same time, what are the roles that they need to play in order to make sure that the women get those opportunities? So it has to go hand in hand, and that ideology need to be something that we really need to work on. And the other thing I would like to highlight is sometimes when women does something that is not perceived to be something that women should do, it's very much highlighted as something, oh, a woman has done this. But if a man does something, it's not highlighted. Even like this really bring me to the important aspect of the media. Media often portrays women in a very different way than it portrays men. Because men are expected to do these things. So it's okay, you don't mention that women does something. But if a woman does something, maybe it may be something like a crime or something. If a woman does that, okay, this woman has done this. The highlight is there. And when the media sees people, especially women in high ranks or people in a managerial or policy level, when they talk to them, it's itself, I feel that there are things that are more attacking in the sense of personally rather than professionally. Like, for example, there might be issues like being a woman, how long do you work, and do you think this is something that you can do being a woman? So that emphasis on being a woman and are you supposed to do these things is actually very demeaning. You shouldn't be asking this, because whether you're a man or a woman, why should it matter? It matters because that we have this negative perception towards gender stereotyping and negative perception towards gender equality, and that gender should be something that is gender equality or rights is something that we really need to think about. And I have experienced a lot of instances where when people ask women about certain things, they are very skeptical about what is the role that you are doing, or why do you think you can do these things, or things like that. Even in interviews, even in different posts, and even in traveling, sometimes when you get opportunities for learning or when you get opportunities for training, there is a perception that, okay, because you are a woman, you may not be able to go, you may not be able to contribute as much. So these perceptions are still there and it exists. And often Maldives being a very male dominant society, it's not very surprising that you observe this even now. And I know a lot of people, even in very high positions, males, who believe that gender equality is not something that we should work on, and women shouldn't be given that opportunity. So if these are the people who are making decisions for us, or have the power and authority to make policies, it would be a huge negative impact on women empowerment as well. Because when they don't understand that women should get equal opportunities and equal rights, and who is going to work towards that as well. And to end, I would like to actually mention a very important aspect that I would like to highlight, is that often we see that more women let down women. Rather than the society or the community, we see that more women does that to women. And when you see women excelling in different areas, there are women who actually let them down. So this is something we shouldn't take lightly. We need more women rooting for other women. We need women empowering other women. We need to stick together. We need to ensure that we are not misused by the community, and we also get these equal opportunities, and we are empowered enough to contribute to the society in all aspects. So if women are not there for other women, I don't know. I think it's a very sad thing, and it's very common in Maldives, and it's sadly something that we have to really acknowledge, understand, and work towards. So these are very crucial issues that I have mentioned here, and I'm sure that some of these things are things that we are already working on. But to highlight all the issues that I believe are still faced by women in the Maldivian community, especially working in different sectors. Okay. Thank you.